meeting, working with regard to the last pensions committee of the municipal year. Unfortunately, I have apologies for the chair of the committee, Councillor Pat Glassman, who's not very well today, unfortunately. I'm sure we'd all want to send our best wishes to Pat. And I also have apologies from from Paul Wiggins, who's a trade union representative, who I understand is all well again now. So
is that an operation?
Yeah. Okay, so as far as I'm aware, there are no other apologies. Okay, members' code of conduct declarations of interest. Any members got any interest in any items of business before us this evening? Yes, Norman?
Good evening, Mr. Chair, member of the Pension Fund.
Any other? Jeff? Thank you, Jeff.
My wife is a member of the Pension Fund.
I'm second.
Okay, they all noted. Thank you. Moving on to the minutes of the meeting held on the 20th of January. Is it agreed that I sign those minutes?
Agreed.
Thank you. Okay, thank you. Item 3 is the audit plan 2013-14. I understand Rob Thornton is going to be presenting on this. Okay, welcome Fiona.
Thank you.
Okay,
I'll just introduce myself to the committee since this is my first meeting. I'm picking up as the audit manager for the external audit from Heather Green, who may have called. She's on maternity leave currently. So I'm just here to present our audit plan for 13-14. Very briefly, Chair, it sets out a range of sort of challenges facing the pension fund, which are not specific to this pension fund, but are very national ones that you're clearly well aware of. There's various updates on tonight's agenda around all of those issues. And we talk about how we will reflect that in our work and in discussions with you. I think one of the things that we are intent on doing as Grant Thornton, because we audit around 30% of pension funds, is to try and pull together whatever we can in terms of comparable data to how you're responding to all these different things to try and help you as much as we can. The plan goes on to talk about the risks identified for the audit. They're all very generic risks to pension funds. We haven't identified any specific risks to this fund. And therefore the work that we plan to do will be the same work that we would do on any other pension fund. And I suppose the other thing just to draw to your attention is that around the work that we're doing on benefit payments is that we have liaised closely with internal audit to try and remove any duplications of